Welcome to Conspiracy Reads, a show where we read into some people's conspiracy theories and see if they are probable or impossible. Today we are looking at Did the World End in 2012? This is a thread of tweets by Nick Hinton. If you're interested in reading more of his conspiracies, or if you want to read along with me, his Twitter will be in the description. Now, without further ado, grab some popcorn and your tinfoil hats, and let's get into it. I've wanted to talk about this subject for a while now. The other day I had a random urge to look into this again and read some of the old stuff. You know, just for fun. Ever since then, I've noticed other people talking about it again. But the strangest part is, I cannot find anything online about it anymore. Like I said, you can find people talking about it casually or joking about it, but I cannot find any of the in-depth material I had read before. This has actually been really frustrating for me, because I have nothing to refresh my memory while writing this. I've found a few things here and there that are helping me piece the puzzle together again, but I know there used to be so much more out there. I can't even remember the first time I've heard of this theory, but it's become somewhat of a meme. I did find a video of Max Langan, that child genius from YouTube, who touched on this theory. But I don't think he's the first to talk about it. I think originally it was some girl. So did the world actually end in 2012? What was the year scientists at CERN had finally found the Higgs boson? You know, the particle Stephen Hawking predicted could destroy the universe? Or in his own words, cause the universe to undergo a catastrophic vacuum decay. Well, what would happen if we destroyed the universe? Would we know? Maybe CERN accidentally created a black hole that sucked us all in without us even noticing, and we've just been living in it. Some physicists actually believe this is possible. There's the old cliche argument that nothing has felt right since 2012. I agree with this. Maybe it has something to do with growing up and getting older, but ever since then it seems like the world descends more and more into chaos each day. Time even feels faster. There's some sort of calamity happening almost daily. Mass shootings only stay in the headlines for like 12 hours now. Did we all die and go to hell? I don't really believe that, but some people do. Maybe we're in a similar situation to the characters in The Good Place? Like I've said before, I think we live in a series of simulations. Perhaps the universe was destroyed by CERN, and our collective consciousness was moved into a parallel universe next door. It would be almost identical. In fact, there are people out there who are reporting small differences in this reality and the one they remember before 2012. This is a phenomenon often referred to as the Mandela Effect. Below is one of the most famous Mandela effects. Some people remember Febreze rather than Febreze. Some people remember Skechers instead of Skechers. Looney Tunes instead of Looney Tunes. JCPenney instead of JCPenney. The list goes on. If these don't look or feel right to you, you're not alone. The name comes from Nelson Mandela, who many believe to have died in a prison in the 80s. However, to many people's surprise, his funeral was national news in 2013, and he had lived a long and happy life. Mandela effects get much creepier though. Some people remember the Statue of Liberty being in a totally different place, that location being Ellis Island. It actually is on Liberty Island. Here's a painting clearly depicting the statue at Ellis Island with no other islands nearby. Was the artist just not paying attention? Did he just like it better this way? I really don't think so. Now, if that's not strange enough, if you go on Google Maps Street View, there's a few specific areas of Liberty Island where the Statue of Liberty is just gone. Residue from the previous timeline? The account uploading these strange pictures goes by the username of August Bartholdy. That's the designer of Lady Liberty herself. The account also sports his picture from the 1800s. He's Google approved. Apparently, right before the United States' entry into World War I, the Germans committed the first act of terrorism on US soil. It was considered one of the largest artificial, non-nuclear explosions to have ever occurred. I'm wondering why I didn't hear about this in school. So anyways, the explosion is the reason the Statue of Liberty's torch is closed to the public. It's been closed for over 100 years. There's only one problem though. People remember going there. Then there's these pictures I found taken from the torch. But just look at the users' profile pictures. Creepy. Were they time travelers? There's also this weirdo Twitter account, which makes no mention of Liberty Island at all, and sports a creepy banner photo of people walking upstairs that lead to nothing. But last but not least, there's this video. It's a collection of Facebook photos where people have tagged their location at Statue of Liberty, Ellis Island. However, the people are posing in front of and staring at nothing. It's really unsettling. Well, anyways, a while back there was a viral thread on 4chan posted by someone who claimed to be one of the 23 scientists at CERN responsible for creating the Mandela Effect. They claimed the planet was destroyed and we were placed in a simulated world. However, the thing I thought was most interesting was that whoever this person was described reality as being like a set of Russian dolls, where there are worlds nestled within one another, or like we've talked about, simulations within simulations. The idea of simulations within simulations, or a multiverse, is not something new. It has been a part of Eastern philosophy since the 3rd century. A quote by Alan Watts illustrates it perfectly. Imagine a multi-dimensional spider web in the early morning covered with dewdrops, and every dewdrop contains the reflection of all the other dewdrops, and in each reflected dewdrop, the reflections of all the other dewdrops in the reflection, and so ad infinitum. That is the Buddhist conception of the universe in an image. This also reminds me of the Turtles All the Way Down myth, the story that the world sits on the back of a turtle, who's standing on a larger turtle, who's standing on an even larger turtle. You get the idea. But anyways, besides the Mayans, there were some other people who predicted 2012 would be the end. One of these was Terrace McKenna. Well, he didn't necessarily believe 2012 would be the end, but he predicted there would be some reality rearranging event. He made this prediction using his time wave zero formula, which supposedly mathematically decodes the King-Wen sequence of the I Ching into something that graphs the fractal patterns of history. The graph culminates in a singularity point of infinite complexity. To better understand this concept, you can imagine a tape wrapped up in a spiral like you find inside a VHS tape. Time goes round and round in smaller loops until eventually it runs out. Is there another meaning to the end of time? Preston B. Nicholas, a supposed whistleblower who wrote books detailing time travel experiments at the Montauk Air Base, claimed that they were never able to time travel past 2012 because they could find no future beyond it. According to him, there was a very abrupt wall there with nothing on the other side. Whether he's a crackpot or not, what I find interesting is he did this interview in 2014. Like, it's just a very strange thing to say considering you've already made it past the date, right? Stranger Things and Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind are actually both loosely based on these supposed experiments. There's also a theory floating around that we've reached the end of history. The end of history is a philosophical idea that has been talked about by such notable figures as Hegel, Marx, and most recently, Francis Fukuyama. At the end of history, events still happen, but humanity has reached the end of its socio-cultural evolution. This theory has nothing to do with time travel or simulations, but rather the stagnation of human progress. I just find it fitting that people think this is happening. It kind of fits this dreamlike purgatory theme. It's this theory I find most when trying to research the topic of the end of the world having already happened. If you think fourth dimensionally or beyond linear time, we could say that the universe has already ended. The moment it began, the end was set in stone. Perhaps the universe is in a constant cycle of expanding and contracting, the Big Bang and the Big Crunch happening over and over, and our souls are just taking a ride on this cosmic Ferris wheel. Thanks for reading. That's some creepy stuff. I want to know what you guys think about all this. Do you think the world really ended in 2012? Or is this just a string of misremembering and coincidences? Let me know in the comments below. Also, let me know what you think of this new series and if there's any way I can improve it in the future. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please leave a like and maybe even subscribe for more great content. We do all the research so you don't have to. And as always, I'm Alex, and I hope you have a fantastic day.
And it cuts deeper than the roots of the trees that we planted in the graveyard. I don't think these scars will ever fade off. Good thing nothing seems to faze us. So numb.